Drawing a still life. Many master artists have created still lives. Still lives consist of objects that are usually common, inanimate, and still, which means they're not moving. Still lifes are great practice for doing value, shape, and space. This still life that I have set up includes a variety of different objects, and depending on where I sit, the view changes, the perspective changes. So I've decided to draw this perspective of my still life. And I'm going to start with a basic regular pencil. This pencil has a light colored lead. It's easier to erase. And I'm going to draw the basic shapes first. So I'm looking at my still life, even though you can't see the still life in this movie right now, I'm looking at it while I'm drawing. So the still life is in front of me and I'm looking constantly, drawing the basic shapes like the squares and the circles and the rectangles, just trying to figure out where all of my shapes and objects are going to be in relation to each other. So I'm figuring out how big things need to be, and I'm keeping my pencil lines light and I'm constantly comparing it to the actual still life. So there I have my basic shapes already drawn out. And now I'm going to go back in and add a few more little details, making sure that my lines are light enough that I can still erase if I need to. And I'm going in adding little more details, little things, more shapes of the skull, more definition to the can. But I'm still using my regular old yellow pencil. I'm not going to add any value just yet because I'm still trying to figure out where all my basic shapes are, figure out where all the details are, and then I can add my value and my shadow. So there I have my basic still life drawn without any value used, and I'm going to compare it to the still life in front of me. Now, there are many different kinds of drawing pencils, and they have different names like HB, 3B, 5B, and Ebony. And depending on the number and the letter combination, the pencils are going to have different shades. So the HB is lighter than the Ebony. The Ebony is the darkest pencil that we use. So I'm going to use an HB pencil to start adding value. That's the lighter one. The reason why we start with the lightest is that if we need to change anything or make a value a little bit lighter in places, or maybe one place needs to be darker than another place, it's easier to do when you start lighter. If I started with the Ebony pencil right away, that would be really, really hard to erase in case I made a mistake. So we're gonna go from the lightest to the darkest. So I'm shading in with my HB pencil, drawing pencil. I'm shading in all of those little shadows that I see, anywhere that there are some shadows, and I'm constantly looking at the still life to make sure I'm getting the shadows right, because I want to make sure they're all on the same side. I'm not making up any of these shadows. I'm only drawing the shadows that I see. Only the ones that I see. I'm going to add a little bit more definition to things, a few more details, and it's starting to look a little bit more realistic with these values. Next, I'm going to use the 3B pencil, and that's going to make it even more dark. So if there's even more dark shadows, I can add some more of the shadow in that 3B pencil, and it's a little bit darker than the HB. Now I'm still looking at that still life to make sure I'm doing the value and the shadows all in the right places. I'm going in and adding some cracks to the skull, a few little things that I missed here and there. Really need to make sure that you're looking. And now I'm going to use the 5B pencil, which is the next darkest shade of drawing pencil. So even darker, I'm making sure that I'm only using this pencil in the darkest shadows. So if there are some really dark shadows, I'm gonna make sure I use this pencil. For the really light shadows, I can just leave them alone. And I can always go back in and add more for shadows. It's very easy to add, but it's kind of tricky to take away, especially when you've darkened one place and maybe you did it in the wrong place. So you really want to be careful while you're adding your shadows. Make sure to add your cast shadows too. Those are the shadows that are cast onto the table or the cart, wherever your still life is. Make sure you draw those cast shadows too. So the shadow on the side of the object and the cast shadow on the table or the cart, the bottom below the still life. And I'm almost finished with adding my drawing pencil. I'm just comparing it again to the real still life. And the last pencil is the ebony pencil. So this is the darkest pencil. I'm only going in where I really, really want those dark, dark values. And this gives me some very nice dark values. It's very difficult to erase, so be very careful, work slowly. Even though this video is sped up a little bit, make sure you work slowly. And take your time, make sure you only add the value where you need to, so you don't have to worry about trying to erase it. Using layers of pencils is also going to help you when you're starting to blend, because you'll have a little bit more graphite to work with to blend the values together. You can use your finger to blend, but I prefer a tortillon or a blending stump to blend the shadows together. And you'll see as I use it, it starts to really fill in together, and it's really nice for getting small areas. So it's easier to use than your finger because I can get into the really small areas and blend it together really nicely. Not to mention, I don't have to worry about getting my finger super full of graphite. So I'm blending my shadows all together, and this is gonna make it look nice and smooth. Now, I might not want to do this if I had a very rough object that I was drawing. If I had a very rough or textured object, I probably wouldn't want to blend because that would kind of smooth it out. It would ruin the texture. But most of my objects are smooth, and most of your objects will probably be smooth too. So I'm just going to use the blending stump to get all of those values shaded, including the cast shadows. It's blending it all together. It's starting to look really nice, really smooth, starting to look like it's actually a finished product. Now you might notice some smudges starting to happen. That's okay. Don't worry about removing smudges until that the very last step. So that's the last thing you got to worry about, because you're going to have smudges throughout the entire process. So there's my finished drawing. It's compared to the still life. You see, I got some graphite on my hand, so I can erase the smudges last step there, making sure I can get rid of all those smudges that I made with my hand and my fingers and picking it up. No big deal. It should be able to be erased pretty easily. And then I'm adding my signature in the lower right-hand corner and the date. I put November 2014, but you could put whatever date you feel like. And you are finished with your still life drawing.